covering Guyana from coast to coast.
Demerara and Essequibo 99.1 FM.
Herbie's 99.5 FM. Kaieteur Radio.
Enjoy free nights talk with Digicel, the curfew edition. Get unlimited free talk to any Digicel number between 9 p.m. to 6 a.m. All you have to do is top up $1,000 or more every day before 6 p.m. to enjoy unlimited free talk. That's a whole lot of gaff. No more boring nights. You can now call your mommy, daddy, your bestie, your boo, even granny to tell them all that Digicel unlimited free night talk is back. Terms and condition apply. Digicel, there with you.
Get ready for the best in Indian mix to make your Thursday night just right. Tune in to Kaieteur Radio 99.1, 99.5 FM every Thursday evening from 9 to 10 for Heartbeats with DJ Viper and Selector Chino. Heartbeats only on Kaieteur Radio.
This is the news on top of the hour.
Live from our studio in Georgetown.
Kaieteur Radio, 99.1 FM.
Good evening and welcome to this evening's newscast right here on Kaieteur Radio. I am Kevin Smith. Let's get to the news in detail. The incumbent APNU AFC has moved to the Court of Appeal to challenge the ruling handed down yesterday by the Chief Justice Roxanne George in the Masinga Jones case. In the court document, the applicant, Masinga Jones, is appealing the whole of the decision by the Chief Justice on the grounds that she erred in law when she ruled, among other things, that the case brought by Jones was res judicata. This means a matter that has been adjudicated by a competent court and therefore may not be pursued further by the same parties. The applicant is also seeking relief so that the judgment by the Chief Justice would be wholly set aside. Let's tell you now that the head of the observer mission of the Organization of American States to Guyana's 2020 elections, Bruce Golding, told the Permanent Council this afternoon that Guyana has failed the litmus test of democracy. Golding said that the litmus test for any democracy is a peaceful and orderly transition of power when the will of the people is expressed. He added that elements attempted repeatedly to produce fraudulent results in favor of the APNU-AFC coalition. The OAS said that the harmful actions of a few have wreaked considerable damage to Guyana's image and reputation, and that even if it is satisfactorily resolved, it will take a generation and significant institutional reform to repair that damage. Meanwhile, Attorney General Basil Williams today falsely stated to the Organization of American States Permanent Council that the Caribbean Court of Justice nullified the recount in its judgment on Irfan Ali versus Eslin David et al. The Caribbean Court stated in a release following its ruling, unless and until an election court decides otherwise, the votes already counted by the recount process as valid votes are incapable of being declared invalid by any person or authority other than the High Court through an election petition. The Chief Justice Roxanne George Wiltshire, in her ruling yesterday, pointed to the CCJ's ruling as she dismissed an application that had sought to invalidate the recount. Meanwhile, Minister of Foreign Affairs Karen Cummings told the Organization of American States Permanent Council to be patient since the Guyanese public has been patient too. This, Cummings said in her address, as she told the council that it should not unduly influence Guyana's constitutional and legal processes. The country has waited 4.5 months for an election declaration, which could be further protracted by more litigation. Cummings said that President David Granger has repeatedly said that he will abide by any declaration made by GCOM, and that no such declaration has been made. Meanwhile, the APNU-AFC coalition has moved to the Court of Appeal to prevent GCOM from declaring the results of the transparent recount. Let's tell you now that according to Sir Ronald Sanders, Guyana's democracy is not being served nor respected as a result of constant delays by the incumbent APNU-AFC to hamper the declaration of the elections. Sir Sanders, during the OAS Permanent Council meeting, stated that the country has been subject to one delay after the next, with the constant court litigations being brought by the APNU-AFC in their bid to frustrate the process. The APNU supporters, he noted, are being encouraged to regurgitate dead matters in the court time and time again. He added that if this was not so, GCOM would have been able to make a declaration months ago to return the country to some form of normalcy. Meanwhile, CARICOM, Canada, Brazil, and Colombia are appealing for GCOM to make a declaration in the March 2nd elections based on the results of the national recount. Representatives of the CARICOM and these three countries called for this during today's meeting of the Permanent Council under the OAS. Let's tell you now that permanent representative of Venezuela to the Organization of American States, Gustavo Tare Briceño, told the Permanent Council that it is the responsibility of the OAS to ensure democracy is adhered to. He called on Guyana to ensure that the election's results are declared as soon as possible. Guyana had joined with other countries of the OAS in 2019 to condemn the Nicolas Maduro government of Venezuela as it had assumed a new term on elections, which were adjudged by international observers as non-credible. Venezuela is currently facing marginalization by the international community for the illegitimacy of its government. Stay tuned. Coming up next is your COVID-19 update.